Hello people, in this video let us look at the complications of cataract surgery. We will be looking at the preoperative complications, operative complications, postoperative. We'll be looking at the early and late complications and also the complications because of the IOL, intraocular lens. So what will happen preoperatively, what and all complications can be there? The patient can have anxiety, then you'll have to give diazepam extra. If they have nausea, gastritis, you'll have to give antacids, etc. for the gastritis. If they have some irritative or allergic conjunctivitis, then you will have to postpone the surgery for 2 days. If they have corneal abrasion, because during this Schiot's tonometry, right, to check the intraocular pressure, isn't it? That time there was a corneal abrasion. That means you have to patch that with the antibiotic ointment and postpone for 2 days. Right, so then complications due to local anesthesia. So due to local anesthesia, there can be retrobulbar hemorrhage can be there, oculocardiac reflex, perforation of the globe can be happen, perforation of the globe. So this is the globe, right? That can happen. So they'll have to use a blunt tipped needle, gentle injection they'll have to give. And peribulbar anesthesia may be preferred. So where is this peribulbar? Peribulbar they have shown here. See, this is peribulbar. Peribulbar. This one is retrobulbar. Okay. Behind the eyeball is retrobulbar. So this is peribulbar. So they seem to be preferring peribulbar. So to avoid the perforation of the globe. Okay. Then subconjunctival hemorrhage can be there. That's a minor complication. Spontaneous dislocation of the lens. Due to weak zonules, degenerated zonules, the lens can go into the vitreous. So dislocation of the lens. So where is the lens? Here. Let's say the lens is here and the zonules are holding the lens. The zonules became weak and the lens got dislocated. Spontaneous dislocation of the lens. When will this happen? Vigorous ocular massage after retrobulbar block. So once you give retrobulbar block, then there looks like they're doing some vigorous ocular massage. Guys, wake up. Yeah, what are we looking at? We are looking at the preoperative complications. They gave retrobulbar block and looks like they did vigorous ocular massage after it. And due to weak degenerated zonules, the lens itself got dislocated. So these are all the preoperative complications that can happen. Now they will start the operation and what and all can happen. Superior rectus muscle laceration can happen. So where is the superior rectus muscle? Somewhere here you can have the superior rectus muscle that can get lacerated. There can be excessive bleeding. So then what will you have? Well, you have to do, you'll have to cauterize. If there's excessive bleeding, you'll have to cauterize. Incision related complications. So the incision can cause some complications. There can be injury to the cornea, guys. Decimates detachment can happen. There can be injury to the iris. There can be injury to the lens, right? Lot of things can happen. So what are they talking about? Due to the incision, there can be some problems. Cornea can get affected. Iris can get affected. Lens also can get injured, right? Injury can happen. So corneas, layers, so many other, in that they're talking about the decimates detachment. Iris injury, iridodialysis can happen. Iris injury, so where are we here? Iris is here and the iris can get injured or it can get separated from its root. That can become iridodialysis, right? Then, where are we here? Complications related to anterior capsular hexis. So there are some complications. This is the lens capsule. So the lens capsule has two things, what? Anterior and posterior. Inside this capsule only lens is there. This is what has become opaque and they want to remove the content of the capsule. So what will happen? They are trying to do anterior capsular hexis and that time there can be some complications. There can also be posterior capsular rupture. So did you understand what exactly they are telling? See, the lens is inside the lens capsule. The lens has become opaque. So now that is what is cataract, which is causing loss of vision. Sorry, defective vision. So they want to remove the lens. So what they want to do? They want to do anterior capsular hexis. Okay. They want to do anterior capsular hexis. Here they want to make a hole and remove the content of the lens. During this, there can be what and all? Complications related to anterior capsular hexis, some complications. Posterior capsule can rupture. Zonular dehiscence. Zonular dehiscence means where are the zonules? They are holding the lens. So there can be zonular dehiscence. Vitreous loss. This is a serious condition, serious complication they are saying. So preoperatively, they want to give mannitol, etc. They want to reduce the pressure, etc. So vitreous loss is serious. You can remember this. Okay. Nucleus drop into vitreous cavity. The nucleus can drop into the vitreous cavity. So the nucleus means this part can drop into the vitreous cavity. So this is vitreous cavity. How did it go there? Okay. So it's a dreadful complication, it seems. And in this case, they have to call the vitreoretinal surgeon. They'll have to go and call a vitreoretinal surgeon. So they have so many specialties. Posterior loss of lens fragments. So lens fragments can be lost. Posterior loss of lens fragments. Expansive choroidal hemorrhage is also serious. This occurs in hypertensives. Okay, guys, let us look. What have we looked at? We have looked at operative complications that can happen. So operative complications, what and all are there, guys? You remember vitreous loss is serious. Nucleus drop into vitreous cavity, dreadful. Expulsive choroidal hemorrhage, you can remember. Then what else do you want to remember? Injury to cornea, remember this one also. Okay. So guys, we are done with preoperative. We are done with operative. Now after the surgery, okay, postoperative, let us look at. In postoperative, you have early and late. Let us look at early now. Early. Okay. So early postoperative complications of cataract extraction. Remember hyphema. Usually no treatment is required. They're saying hyphema means blood in anterior chamber, isn't it? So this is anterior chamber. Blood can be there in anterior chamber. It can get spontaneously absorbed, or they might have to treat it. Okay, usually they don't need any treatment. So this is how it will look. Blooded anterior chamber, hyphema. Okay, this is early postoperative. Iris prolapse, sag out, reposited back. So if the iris is going to sag out, so iris prolapse. Okay, striate keratopathy, mild corneal edema with decimates folds. No treatment is required, or if treatment is required, they are giving hypertonic saline drops. So what are they talking about? Keratopathy, striate keratopathy. So something with the cornea, the decimates, some folds. So the mild corneal edema with decimate folds. Okay, that is striate keratopathy. Don't forget this. Hyphema also don't forget. These are all early postoperative. A flat shallow anterior chamber can happen due to wound leak, ciliochoroidal detachment, or pupillary block. You'll have to treat it with acetazolamide, looks like. Okay, overall we are telling you, but details you'll have to look at. So anterior chamber, flat shallow. Anterior uveitis can happen. Anterior uveitis means what? Inflammation of the iris and part of the ciliary body, right? So that will be anterior uveitis. So they are talking about standard treatment of anterior uveitis, steroids, cycloplegic, NSAIDs, etc. Then what else you can have as a complication? TASS, toxic anterior segment syndrome. So here this is because of the inflammation that is excited by either the ethylene gas, which is used for sterilizing IOLs. So they use something like a ethylene gas to sterilize the IOL, that is the intraocular lens, which they are going to place. That is causing an inflammation, or by the lens material itself. In late cases, there can be TASS. TASS can be in early postoperative, and it can be in late postoperative also. There also you will see, what are we looking at? Wow, TASS. Is there a TASS here? I didn't write here. But anyways, guys, they are saying it can be there in late also because of lens material. So what are they talking about here? Did it make any sense to you? Okay, let's look at this. See, basically what they want to do, this lens has become opacified, so they want to remove this crystalline lens, and they want to put an intraocular lens, artificial lens here. Okay, now what they are saying is, this one they sterilized using some ethylene gas, that can cause this anterior UV, whatever, toxic anterior segment syndrome. Okay, TASS, because of what? The ethylene gas, which was used to sterilize the IOL. Or in the late cases, the TASS can be caused because of the lens material. When they're saying lens material, what is it? Our lens? Our own lens? Guys, you know what? They have written toxic anterior segment syndrome in IOL related complications. So that makes sense, right? It is because of the IOL. Okay, then early postoperative, there can be bacterial endophthalmitis. Remember, this is also very bad. This is infection, right? Endophthalmitis. This is dreaded complication they are saying. Dreaded complication. So this can be, contamination because of some instruments or surgeon's hands or the patient's own flora from the conjunctiva, the bacteria on the conjunctiva, etc. So this is really bad, they are saying. There can be hypopyon and all as symptoms that no, endophthalmitis, you have seen video. So how will you do? You'll give antibiotics, etc. We have video on endophthalmitis, guys. Remember, the inner structures of the eyeball, uveal tissue, retina, vitreous cavity, anterior chamber, posterior chamber, all are affected, looks like. Okay, So what should you know here? How will you treat intravitreous antibiotics, vancomycin, cefazidime, or they can even, okay, that much you remember, okay? So this is endophthalmitis. This is dreaded complication, they are saying. So that is why they are saying these bacteria, right, like Staphylococcus and all can cause this problem. So see, they're painting pre-operative povidone iodine. They're putting some thing here. So all this is required, you know, so that they can not, bacteria can not be there, and they can do a sterile kind of a surgery. So they are saying even before the surgery, they should give moxifloxacin, gutifloxacin, topical. Guys, it's topical antibiotics, okay? So that photo was kind of incorrect. So we are done with early post-operative complications after cataract surgery. Can you summarize what and all you will see after immediately after surgery? Hyphema, yes. Bacterial endophthalmitis, just now you saw. Toxic anterior segment syndrome. Then, what else do you remember, guys? Anterior uveitis. Okay, anterior uveitis. Then, flat, shallow anterior chamber. Okay, then, something to do with the cornea. Striate keratopathy. Yes, striate keratopathy. Iris prolapse. Yeah, hyphema we mentioned. So just see if you got it. Hyphema, iris prolapse, striate keratopathy, flat anterior chamber, anterior uveitis, toxic anterior segment syndrome, bacterial endophthalmitis. See, guys, if you go by this, you will be very easily able to say hyphema, iris prolapse, striate keratopathy, then flat anterior chamber, post-operative anterior uveitis, toxic anterior segment syndrome, bacterial endophthalmitis. Now, guys, let's move on to the delayed complications. Is it fine, guys? Delayed complications? Let's move on. So, cystoid macular edema, this is a very frequent complication, but nothing needs to be done. It is clinically insignificant. Look at this. Fundus fluorescein angiogram showing flower petal appearance. Look at this, of cystoid macular edema. In the macular area, you can see some flower petal appearance, and in OCT picture, you can see cystoid spaces. Okay, so this is cystoid macular edema. So this will be a delayed complication. Okay, so where will it be? Cystic loculi in Henle's layer of macula. If you want to remember some extra words here, in Henle's layer of macula, okay, that is where they will have cystic loculi. So where is macula? Here, right? And there is some edema, cystoid edema, cystoid macular edema. Okay, how's it going, people? What are we looking at? Delayed complications of cataract surgery. Very good. So then delayed endophthalmitis. So there you saw endophthalmitis even in the early one. Now there can be delayed also. This will be usually due to low virulence organisms like propion bacterium, acne, or staph epidermidis. Barely it can be because of fungus. So this is, they don't like this, right? Dreaded, they said endophthalmitis and all. So they can give treatment, or they can do pars plana vitrectomy and give all antibacterial, antifungal based on whatever is causing it. Okay. Then pseudophakic bullous keratopathy. So pseudophakic means what? Now they have put the artificial lens, so that will become pseudophakic. Bullous keratopathy, insults to corneal endothelium during surgery. During surgery, they have looks like they have done something to the corneal endothelium. So now corneal endothelium gone means they have to do what? Corneal transplant. See, now they were doing IOL they were doing surgery, and this endothelium, that is the inside layer of the cornea, got damaged. So now what will happen? There is, what is the word they are saying? Pseudophakic bullous keratopathy. So now they'll have to do corneal transplant. So you went for cataract surgery, and then you will have to get a corneal transplant also if this happens. Retinal detachment can happen in aphakia, yes, retinal detachment, or if there is vitreous loss, there can be retinal detachment as a late complication. Where did you see vitreous loss? Do you remember seeing vitreous loss anywhere? Here, in operative complication, there is vitreous loss. It's a serious condition, and now you know that it can lead to retinal detachment late. Late delayed complication. Okay, retinal detachment, vitreous loss, epithelial ingrowth. See, wherever they made the incision, looks like From there, the corneal conjunctival epithelium can invade the anterior chamber. How strange, right? The conjunctival epithelium can invade the anterior chamber from that incision point, looks like. Okay. And that can lead to a stubborn glaucoma, intractable glaucoma. So where is conjunctiva? It's a mucous membrane, which is here, right? This is where the conjunctiva is. At least the bulbar conjunctiva is here. So now the epithelium of this conjunctiva is growing into the anterior chamber. Strange, right? Because of the incision wherever they had made. And now it will lead to what? A stubborn glaucoma. Guys, then fibrous downgrowth, this is also can cause secondary glaucoma. So glaucoma, which is coming after the surgery, secondary glaucoma. After cataract, guys, after cataract is after this cataract surgery, this guy got cataract again. That is after cataract or secondary cataract. Here, there can be posterior capsular opacity. We have already seen this, isn't it? After cataract. So remember, after cataract or that is after the cataract surgery, you will get cataract. After cataract, secondary cataract. So basically cataract, what it is and all we have seen in this video. So basically here posterior capsular opacification. So you can see this dense membranous somber rings, ring Elshnick pearls, all this, right? So a lot of types of posterior capsular opacification. So how will you treat? YAG laser capsulotomy. Okay, YAG laser capsulotomy. I've shown here. Bring to front. See, laser beam, see behind, it is going behind this artificial lens, intraocular lens, and they are doing, see earlier there was a posterior capsule opacity, for that only they are putting this laser beam. Which laser? YAG laser. That is what is cap after cataract. And when will after cataract come? It's a delayed complication of cataract extraction. Okay, so we are done with delayed complications, guys. Delayed complications, do you want to summarize? After cataract, delayed endophthalmitis, late what will happen, you tell, after lot, the glaucoma, some glaucomas are developing because of that conjunctival thing, fibrous downgrowth, then what else is going to happen? Late complication, cystoid macular edema is late, don't forget, pseudophakic bullous keratopathy, that guy will land up getting a penetrating keratoplasty, retinal detachment can happen. Okay, so this is about delayed complications, guys. Let's move on. IOL related complications. Are you still there and awake? IOL related complications last. Okay, we'll finish off. So what will be the same? Cystoid macular edema can be there. Malposition of IOL. IOL itself didn't get positioned properly. It went off down means sunset syndrome. If it is up, went off up means sunrise syndrome. If it went off back somewhere into the vitreous, lost lens syndrome. Or if you move your head, the superior loop is moving left and right. That is windshield wiper syndrome. Okay. So sunset sunrise, lost lens syndrome and windshield wiper syndrome. Then pupillary capture of IOL. Looks like the pupil is capturing the IOL because of iritis or something, right? They were telling that only, right? So where is the iris? Iris is here, right? Looks like it is capturing the IOL. Then they already told you, right? Toxic anterior segment syndrome because of the lens matter. Delayed. This is one of the delayed complication. Toxic anterior segment syndrome, you can see even in the early and in the IOL related complications late because of that. Early, what did we see? In TASS, because of that ethylene gas. Yeah, ethylene gas used for sterilizing the IOL. Because of that, there can be uveal inflammation. That is toxic anterior segment syndrome. If they ask you in the exam just toxic anterior segment syndrome, remember it's an early post-operative complication of cataract extraction due to the ethylene gas which is used for sterilizing the IOLs, or it can also be a late complication because of the IOL lens material itself. Okay, that's all, guys. We are done with all the complications after cataract surgery. Let's take a recap. Complications of cataract surgery, we can classify them as preoperative, operative, early postoperative, late postoperative, and because of the IOL. And because of the IOL. So you can include that here itself, right, in complications of cataract surgery. So preoperatively, the patient can have anxiety, nausea, gastritis, allergic conjunctivitis, corneal abrasion due to the tonometry. Complications can be there because of local anesthesia like retrobulbar hemorrhage, oculocardiac reflex. perforation of the globe, subconjunctival hemorrhage, spontaneous dislocation of the lens, because after the retrobulbar block they are doing some vigorous ocular massage, and weak and degenerated zonules because of which the lens can get dislocated into the vitreous. Operative what and all can be there: superior rectus muscle laceration, excessive bleeding, incision related complications, cornea injury can happen, injury to the iris, iridodialysis. Complications can be related to the anterior capsular hexis, posterior capsular rupture can happen, zonular dehiscence, vitreous loss which is serious, nucleus drop into the vitreous cavities, again dreadful complication, posterior loss of lens fragments, expulsive choroidal hemorrhage which is also serious. Okay, then early post-operative guys, hyphema, iris prolapse, striate, keratopathy, flat anterior chamber, anterior uveitis, toxic anterior segment syndrome guys, then bacterial endophthalmitis, all these are early. What are delayed? Cystoid macular edema, delayed endophthalmitis, pseudophakic bullous keratopathy, retinal detachment, epithelial ingrowth, fibrous downgrowth, all these can lead to secondary glaucoma after cataract. Because of the IOL, what and all can happen? Cystoid macular edema, malposition of the IOL, sunset, sunrise, lost lens, windshield wiper syndrome, pupillary capture of the IOL, toxic anterior segment syndrome. So all this we have looked at in detail also, right, in this video. So this is the video on complications of cataract surgery, guys. Bye-bye.